Enjoy it to smoke a joint behind the wheel of a car. That's the nicest thing you can do, to drive to a faraway place and to have a nice joint and have good music on the radio.
Do you think it's safe?
It's perfectly safe. I think it's 200% safe. Well, you shouldn't be with a crowd, you know. If you get in a crowd with people in your car, you have to be careful because you can get distracted. But if you're alone with your music and you just get concentrated on driving, and it's very nice. I like that.
Under simulated test conditions, marijuana does not affect one's ability to drive, according to Dr. Alan C. Donaldson of the National Safety Research Institute in Ann Arbor, Michigan, which is funded by the United States government. However, common sense and good judgment would dictate that drugs and driving not be mixed. I hoped that day, as I drove to Amsterdam, that most of the Dutch drivers were exercising good judgment. In that same part of Amsterdam can also be found many of Holland's oldest coffee shops, which sell marijuana and hashish openly to the public. However, on this trip, I was not interested in the soft drug scene. I had come to investigate a new phenomenon which experts believe involves 90% of all Dutch coffee shops. First, using a clean knife, fresh oranges are sliced into halves. Then the halves are squeezed, extracting the juice. The oranges are usually imported from Florida or Brazil. The orange juice junkie may sit in a coffee shop for quite a long time, drinking glass after glass, even foregoing the usual pleasures of marijuana or hashish. Actually, we're kidding about orange juice addiction, but they really do sell a great deal of fresh squeezed orange juice at these coffee shops here in Holland that sell marijuana and hashish. They also sell lots of sandwiches, coffee, tea, and tobacco. Speaking of coffee, tea, and tobacco, you might be very surprised to learn that these three ordinary things were once illegal in some part of the world. It's really true, but believe it or not, coffee was once illegal in many parts of the Arab world, such as Egypt, back in the 16th century. And tobacco was illegal in many parts of Germany, Switzerland, and France back in the 17th century. The penalty for smoking tobacco in Russia, India, Turkey, and Persia in the 16th century was death. And in England, King James, about this time, hated tobacco smoking. He tried to ban it by imposing a 4,000% tax. At that point, tobacco smoking became even more popular. King James lost that fight. He had to lower his tax to a more acceptable level. Even tea was prohibited once in Egypt about the turn of the century. And in Ireland in the 1930s, the prime minister there tried to get tea banned to protest British influence in Ireland. Here I interviewed one of the chess players, an individual who chose to give up his American citizenship in return for what he says is more freedom in Amsterdam.
My name is Barry Kevenay.
Barry, please. Actually, you don't have to use your own name.
That's okay. Back in the States, I worked for marijuana law reform.
And oh,
I
did
stood
you?
Up in the public eye, and I stood up in the city halls, and I spoke about it. You know,
oh, right.
The USA is really into this perfect propaganda, if you ask me, of the drug wars.
Right.
This drug wars lets them beat down their own people who would object, and also it's the excuse to invade Central and South America, which they're doing under the pretense of controlling drugs.
Barry, you've decided to at least live over here for the time being, haven't you?
I intend to live here until I die, because here I can live the freedoms that the USA only promised me. I don't have to argue about it, I can live it. And I feel that I'm an expatriate by definition, but I was one of the patriots. I was one of the USA Yankee patriots. And this is where I've had to wind up. The Dutch have a very unique experiment that the world, that we all could profit from hearing more about.
So what are you doing? Oh, you're making a flower arrangement.
Yeah, what am I doing?
What are these?
These are blossoms, you know, from the trees outside, apple blossom, or I don't know what kind of blossom, but they don't grow unless you open up the end.
Oh, I see. So the water can get in.
Yeah.
So you're one of these Dutch horticulturists.
Pardon?
You're like a Dutch horticulturist. Horticulture.
I don't know what it is.
That's plant science.
No, of course not. It's kind of common knowledge.
So how many years have you been smoking marijuana and hashish? Kari?
20 years.
20 years?
Yes.
But you don't smoke so much anymore though, do you?
I started when I was 19 years just by using marijuana. That was not available that time as much, but hashish.
Hashish.
Hashish, yes, only for the weekend or on Saturday evening, you know, having a joint. And then I started smoking more, like also halfway the week, you know, it's getting more a habit. And of course it increased smoking every day, because when we start growing ourselves, so you have always grass, and it's easy to smoke every day then. But since, I don't know when, when I smoke a lot, you know, it's going like this and then going down again, because it's not so much fun anymore. Smoking always and being always stoned or high, just getting too common.
So you're tired of it?
Well, no, not tired. I wouldn't like if it was not there, because I enjoy it more than alcohol.
So now it would be only for special occasions.
I get very sleepy from joint, and I get very speedy.
Oh, so if you smoke marijuana, you have trouble sleeping?
Trouble sleeping.
You sleep better without smoking?
Without, yeah.
Really? You sleep better without smoking?
But that's very personal, because you know I also think that's changing. Because in the beginning I can think of situations where I just fall asleep like a log, and now it takes me 5 hours to recover one joint.
So how many years have you worked in this coffee shop?
This one's a violence only from people who drink alcohol.
Only drunk people?
Yeah.
Well, Corey, thank you very much, and I'll let you finish this.
Thank you.